There is a question that is often flung at the face of the believers. That is, if God is God, why is there so much evil and sufferings in our world today? To answer this question, first of all, one needs to know as to what this world is all about. According to the Bible, God created Lucifer in such splendor and beauty that he was called the seal of perfection. At one point, he was lifted up in pride and wanted to take over God's throne. One third of God's angels sided with him. This led to a revolt in heaven. The Bible explains the conflict as follows.
And there was war in heaven. Michael and his angels fought against the dragon, and the dragon fought and his angels, and prevailed not, neither was their place found any more in heaven. And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil and Satan, which deceiveth the whole world. He was cast out into the earth, and his angels were cast out with him.
This one incident is the reason behind God creating all of us. It doesn't make sense, does it? Let me explain. When Lucifer rebelled, God could have annihilated him at once, but he did not. Instead, he turned our planet into a case study for the angels to see for themselves that Lucifer is nothing more than a boaster who cannot deliver. In fact, God has given Lucifer a chance to prove himself in our tiny planet by establishing a kingdom that would last forever like God's kingdom in heaven. So, ever since the time of creation, Lucifer has been trying to build a permanent kingdom on earth. There were Sumerian, Egyptian, Babylonian, Persian, Greek, Roman, and many other mighty kingdoms on earth. But they all collapsed like decks of cards. By the way, how do we know that Lucifer the devil is behind all these kingdoms? Well, one day the devil showed all the kingdoms of the earth to Jesus and said the following.
I will give you all their authority and splendor, for it has been given to me.
And I can give it to anyone I want to, so if you worship me, it will all be yours.
It is written, worship the Lord your God and serve him only.
This explains that the devil is behind all these kingdoms and power structures. And again, I said that the earth is a case study for angels to observe. Now, are the angels watching the events in our planet like spectators at a basketball game? Oh yes, Jesus once said the following about anyone that chooses to repent of his sins and come back to God.
I say unto you, joy shall be in heaven over one sinner that repenteth more than over 99 just persons which need no repentance.
This shows that God's angels watch every action of each individual on earth. Now, coming back to our story, there is going to be one more final kingdom of Lucifer, which will excel all his previous kingdoms. This is known as the Antichrist Kingdom, also known as the
New World Order, a world where the rule of law, not the law of the jungle, governs the conduct of nations. When we are successful, and we will be, we have a real chance at this new world order, an order in which a credible United Nations can use its peacekeeping role to fulfill the promise and vision of the UN's founders.
According to the Bible, this kingdom will last for a very short time before it also collapses. Finally, God's kingdom will be established on the earth, and the angels learn that God is always right. However, that day has not come yet. That is why even today, Christians all over the world pray the Lord's Prayer, saying, Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven, and so on. So, why is there so much evil and sufferings in our world today? Well, it is the fruit of all the ungodliness and greed that Lucifer promoted through ages, backfiring straight at him and the humanity. Blaming God for any of these is plain ignorance, don't you think? Thanks for watching.